Databases keep the digital world running smoothly. Whether it's a small business or a global enterprise, they store, organize, and protect mountains of data. But here's the kicker. They're also prime targets for hackers. Why? Because controlling a database can mean stealing data, causing chaos, or just flexing some malicious skills. Let's break down how attackers pull off one of the most common tricks, SQL injection, and more importantly, how to keep your databases safe. Oh, and before we start, this is all for educational purposes only. Don't go rogue and try this out on any systems you don't own or have explicit permission to test. Seriously, no one wants to deal with angry lawyers. Imagine you're trying to log in somewhere, and instead of putting in a password, someone just writes, admin or 1 equals 1. Boom, they're in. No password needed. That's SQL injection in a nutshell. Attackers insert sneaky bits of code into SQL statements. If successful, they can access, modify, or even destroy data. For example, a hacker might bypass passwords with a clever login input. Or instead of searching for a keyword, they might inject a code to fetch every single record in a database. In the most dramatic cases, they can destroy data entirely with a command like drop table users, goodbye user data. Now let's talk about SQLmap, an open source tool designed for both good and bad actors. Think of it as the Swiss Army knife of SQL injection testing. It automates the process of finding and exploiting vulnerabilities in databases. SQLmap can do a lot, from fingerprinting databases to extracting data, bypassing login forms, and even executing system commands. Installing SQLmap is straightforward. It's pre-installed on Kali Linux and Parrot OS. If you're on Ubuntu or Debian, just run apt install SQLmap. Mac users can use Homebrew with brew install SQLmap. Once you're set up, the help menu, SQLmap-h, is your go-to for understanding its commands. If you suspect a website or app might be vulnerable, SQLmap can test it. You start by scanning a URL like this. SQLmap-u, followed by the site's URL, --dbs. If the database is vulnerable, SQLmap can list tables, dump data, and much more. For instance, you can explore a database with SQLmap-u, followed by the site's URL, --d, followed by the database's name --tables, or even dump data using SQLmap-u, followed by the site's URL --d, then the database's name -t, followed by the table's name, then --dump. The tool has plenty of features, including setting cookies and faking user agents, so diving into the documentation is worth it. If you're looking to level up your skills in cybersecurity, I've got just the thing. Over at my WAP store, I'm building the best cybersecurity community on the planet. We've got courses, quizzes, and a Discord full of some great hackers. It's the perfect place to sharpen your skills and take your learning to the next level. So if you want to join the crew and start cracking the code, head over there and sign up. Now that we know how attackers break in, let's talk about defense. First, use parameterized queries. These placeholders protect against malicious inputs. Second, sanitize inputs. Don't trust anything users submit. Check for weird characters or unexpected code. Third, use prepared statements, which are like parameterized queries but precompiled and even more secure. Strong access controls are another must. Keep your database behind locked digital doors. Finally, monitor activity. Set up alerts for suspicious queries or login attempts to catch issues early. Databases are the unsung heroes of modern tech, and keeping them secure is non-negotiable. Tools like SQLmap are powerful for both testing and defending against vulnerabilities, so it's worth learning the ins and outs. If you liked this video or have feedback, let me know in the comments. Got questions? Drop those too. And don't forget to check out the WAP store to join our amazing community of hackers. Until next time, stay curious and stay secure.